Will, future Will, this is the episode you've been training your whole life for. Throwing some air horns. Throwing a girl eating a burrito. Throw in, it's hip to fuck bees.
It's hip to fuck bees!
Yeah, very nice. And, find a picture of a gym, find a picture of a gymquisition shrimp, put it in the top left corner of the video for the rest of the video. We're back with Sonic Adventure. We're back with Sonic Story. I don't know how many levels I'm going to do in this episode, but let's keep going. Let us keep going. Faux show. Last episode of Sonic Adventure, we left off. Will, hey Will, future Will, is that shrimp still there? Oh, okay. Oh, it is. Okay, good. Last episode we had just like dished about some things. I was rather cranky last episode, but it felt dang good throwing out all that raw emotion. That is fantastic. Okay, I'll go to the casino. Today I'm not really frustrated about anything. My voice is just kind of sore. Not for a sickness related reason. Luckily, it was because I was over visiting my grandmother, and geez, man, she knows how to talk your ear off. We were just chatting for like 4 hours straight. So my voice is a little shot right now because it's only been like an hour since I got home, but that's okay. Nothing wrong with the more quiet and chill and sobering episode. That's nice. You know, this'll be a video that you can fall asleep to. You know, if I could just get right up into the mic here. If I could just get right up into the mic. I'll even talk like a little bit above the microphone. Just so that you don't actually hear the microphone popping at any time. At least I hope not. If it does end up popping, then I apologize. But we're not going to do the rest of the video like this. It's just something I'm going to carry on for until we get to Twinkle Park, which is not a far walk. We're just going to walk around the corner, leave the hotel, and it's just on the other side of the street here. It is a very strangely shaped street, so it's a bit deceptive to say it's just across the street, as it is slightly farther. Hey, here we are! Ooh, Twinkle Park. Ain't that fantastic? I don't know why the screen just flashed red. I don't know. Anyway, just a couple episodes ago, we saw this from the perspective of Amy, so now we're actually seeing Sonic being a bit more heroic, rather than seeing Amy's cunning exploits. You still see them, but a little less emphasized this time around. Kind of just look over and we're like, oh my god, Amy. You're so dumb. She's not even looking at a sign. There's no sign there that says couples get in free.
Amy!
Wait! I actually, an early draft for the next episode of Amnesia was actually very similar to what I was just doing with like the soft whispering and stuff. I was going to do an entire episode of Amnesia in like ASMR. That was the plan. I decided to scrap it. I just felt it was like kind of gimmicky and tacky. But I don't know. Maybe I'll attempt it again or something. But that was like an early draft of the upcoming episode, and you guys would have been one Amnesia episode richer. But I didn't feel like it was very high quality. It was like the first. It was the first episode in a very long time. I watched it back and I was like, this is like just not enjoyable on any level. So I just decided to say screw it, dude. I got the magenta one, and I'm dead. Oh no, I'm not dead. Oh my gosh. Yeah, we're in a bumper car now. This is kind of a weird mechanic. What the hell? Okay. I guess getting that rabbit in the car was like bumping into a solid wall. But yeah, this is kind of like a one-time sort of thing here. Didn't we do... I think we did this already, right? With another character? I'm pretty sure we did. Whatever, right? Whatever. But, well, actually, maybe not. I don't know. I can't remember. I would have to look at my emblems in trial mode, I guess, to see. I feel like I did it already, but maybe not. Might be the first time. You're able to do like a mini game called Twinkle Circuit, with every character, and it's basically just a time trial run of a different looking course. The controls are not great for this. If you want my honest opinion, I think it's a fun, like, minute and a half diversion, you know? If I'm gonna be sitting here bitching about what is literally 90 seconds of the entire game, then I've got bigger things to worry about in my life. Apparently I don't have bigger things to worry about. I need bigger things to worry about. And, I rightfully do, so, you know, I really don't care about complaining about this. Woo! It's just, woo, look me go! I like the little blur effects. I like that. It is funny to see, like, the textures and the distance, like, popping into full clarity, though. Like, literally, like, 10 feet in front of Sonic. There is something kind of interesting about it. There's something almost hypnotic about watching the textures. Textures. Just, like, come into full focus. Something hypnotic about it. Oh, I love Twinkle Park, man! I love this music. This is definitely one of my favorite tracks in the game. Ice Cap is still my favorite. There's no debating that. Just on any level. Ice Cap, when you're riding on the snowboard, is the best song in this game. Emerald Coast is pretty cool, though. Emerald Coast pretty cool. Twinkle Park's pretty cool. Red Mountain. Both sections of Red Mountain, I think, are kind of interesting. One's kind of like a basic, you know, mountainy, basic Sonic sounding level, and then you get inside of Red Mountain and it's all like R&B, jeez, like almost hip hoppy kind of. I think it's super cool. We were there once already, the one that has the music. It was a Gamma stage. I think I was talking about being an old fart or something. Isn't that what I was talking about in that episode? Might be. Will, I just want to check in with you again. That shrimp is still up in the corner, right? I don't want that shrimp leaving. I don't, you know, Jim Sterling doesn't own the rights to that shrimp. You keep that shrimp up there for as long as possible. All right? I don't even care, dude. Whoa, oh god. Oh, shite. Oh my god, I effed it. There we go, okay. Took me a while to get back up here, good lord. That section of Twinkle Park, I'm like always consistently horrible at it. I'm not taking any chances along this part here. There we go. Just with the game running at like 30 frames a second and all. Running along here can get kind of wonky because the controls get a little wonky because you're running on an angle. There we go, yeah. Play it nice and safe with the light speed dash. Sonic Adventure DX, you kind of have more freedom to move around because it's all in 60 frames, so. There we go. Very nice. Yes! Yes! Perfect, dude. Yeah, not bad. So that is Twinkle Park. Here we go. Now we have to get some cutscene stuff out of the way now, because as we recall from Amy's story, then we have this whole thing with like Zero and stuff, so. Let's get all that out of the way.
Welcome to Twinkle Park.
Oh, shoot! I've lost Amy. I bet that robot hauled butt after her.
Hauled butt?
I better catch her before it does.
Man, I guess that fucking robot just hauled ass after that bit. Like, just like throwing all of the exclamations possible. Oh, there's Speed Highway. Oh, nice, dude. Speed Highway. Oh, is that, I think that's... Oh, I thought we had a cutscene coming up next, but no, I guess not. We will squeeze in a short trip to Speed Highway, then. I am super fast at Speed Highway, so I'll have a lot of fun with this. Speed Highway is one of my favorite actual, like, Sonic levels to play, so... It's just so much fun. There we go. Just felt like I had to put down the card, you know? It's a little grimy. I just found it sitting in the middle of the grass. Oh yeah, Speed Highway, man. It's so much fun. I love it with Sonic. Start with a spin dash. And, ooh. Skip the loop altogether. Hell yeah. Love it. Love it. I believe this was one of the first promotional images, or like this level at least. This level was one of the first promotional images shown off by Sonic Team about this game. I think. Pretty sure it was this one. There you go. Yeah, always make sure you skip the speed shoes there. You run a little too fast for this top path when you have the speed shoes. Sometimes you can fall off the side. Or just, like, completely wreck your momentum. There. You wanna run fast in this level, but you also wanna run consistently. So if you can avoid the huge bursts of speed that you have next to no control over, I would recommend it. I would recommend it. You know, like, I'm pretty dang good at this game. And even I try to avoid them, so. There we go, though. Look at that, we're at this part already and we're not even a minute in, right? The A-rank mission, I believe, has you doing this one in, I want to say 2.5 minutes, but it might be 3 minutes. One of those two. But I don't know, let's see how fast we can do it, right? I'll actually try to, like, challenge myself here, and yeah, I screwed that up right there. Damn it. Damn it. In this version of the game, that last jump right there sometimes glitches out and just, like, doesn't run you all the way up the ramp, so it ruins the height of your jump. It's a pain in the arse, but, you know, it's just what happens. There we go. So now we're running down the building. This was so cool, man. I shouldn't try to beat along with the music. It'll be out of sync, because that's just how the encoding of the files work. I shouldn't be doing that. But what I should be doing is, oh my god, man! Yeah, you know what? The time limit might be 2.5 minutes, because you can definitely get to the goal ring in 30 more seconds from here. If you're super good. Which is not me. I would probably need, yeah, see, look, I just got hit by a car. That's actually common for hedgehogs living in America, but, you know, it was definitely less graphic as portrayed in this game. I wonder if Sonic in general ever, like, advocated, like, not hitting, like, animals on the street. You know, I feel like he would be, like, a really big advocate for that. Look at that. Look at that. If it wasn't for me being a clumsy piece of shit, I would have gotten that perfect right there. God damn, dude! That would've been awesome. Collect our points here. Our point. I think that's how you say some weird word like that in French. Is that how you say points? Point. Point. I might be thinking of the word point, but I might be using a different context. Maybe it's not like actually like game points. Point. Point. How do you spell point? P-W soft E soft N. Point. Oh, well done. Well, you're so stupid. So dumb. You'll have to find Amy, of course. Now, I believe in order to find Amy, those stupid train people are on their strike now. They've alluded to it a couple times, but now they're on their strike. But you come out here, and I believe this is what.
Amy?
Yeah.
Oh man, where can she?
Because then Sonic looks up in the actual tunnel where the subway is.
Sonic, help!
And he's like, wait! No, he's already said that, but you guys know what I mean. I'll cut him off at the Mystic Ruins. Oh shit, man! It really would be great if characters, like, swore more in Sonic. Not, like, lame swearing, like in Shadow the Hedgehog, where it sounds, like, just really dumb and forced. Like, no, just, like, legitimate swears. Just imagine if Sonic was like, oh, you fucking asshole! Goddamn, Tails! That'd just be... I think that'd just be great. I think that'd just be fantastic. Obviously, that fact alone would make for a 10 out of 10 game, because reasons.
Hey there, bolt brain. You better get Amy to me or I'll.
Yeah, man, you don't even have fully rendered fingers on your hands. Well, I mean, neither does Sonic, but Sonic has his, Sonic has, like, slightly more pronounced, like, Sonic R popsicle stick hands. You know, like, he's got a ring around, he's got, like, a ring along, like, the cuff of his glove,
hey,
and he has a thumb.
Here?
So, you know, like, an actual, like, opposable thumb. You know, Sonic R. Sonic also had a thumb, but it was more just like an extra couple vertexes on the polygon that just kind of jutted out from what would originally be a very trapezoidal, very trapezoidal popsicle stick hand.
Shoot, I've lost her again.
Yeah, dude, totally screwed you. Totally screwed ya. Well, I guess I'll see you guys in the next episode. You know, hopefully when I can raise my voice a bit more, be a bit more expressive. This was a nice chill episode though. I had a great time. Will in the future. That shrimp better still be up there. Okay, good, it is. I saw it. I saw it with my own two eyes. With my future vision. It was magical, really. It came out of nowhere. It was actually rather daunting and traumatizing. Peace!